Okay, we start with the next session. This is the last session for the long day. I briefly introduce myself. I'm from Pivotal. I'm in the cloud computing department, cloud platform architect. Today, I will talk about the cloud native continuous deliverable application and the platform. This is the KubeCon and CNCF that is the cloud native computing foundation. So let's first take a look at the cloud native. Cloud native in the Pivotal magazine. It has four parts. The first one is DevOps, the integration of development and operation. They are not separate. We use some tools and actions to integrate development and ops. It's more about the process and procedure. The second part in the cloud native concept is continuous deliverable and integration. It's more about the tools. We can use the tools and tool chains to realize the DevOps. And also the microservice and the container technology. These are the other two parts of the cloud native. The microservice. We also have seen more and more work on the design of a microservice, especially for cloud migration. How can we turn it into cloud native microservice? And whether it's Docker or the Kubernetes, they provide the container technology and the container orchestration technology. These are the four technologies in the cloud native, and what is the relationship among them? We can see microservice and containers or technologies. What are the purposes? The purpose is to realize the automation of development and operation. So from the perspective of business value, the functions can be launched into the market as soon as possible so that the users can use the functions. And for the DevOps, it's more about the culture of procedures through the CI/CD and other tools. We can realize that we can use microservice and the containers and DevOps and the continuous delivery to make sure the applications can fast respond to the changes and can be launched very fast. By building the microservice in the different environments of production, we can have continuous delivery. So today, our focus on the CI/CD. How can we use our tools for the continuous delivery and continuous platform? Now, we take a look at CI/CD. If you are engaged in development and operation, you know about CI/CD, but to give you a deeper understanding, I can show you the definition. The CI, or continuous integration, refers to the changes you make on the code chain. And the changes should be combined into a major branch by the automated tests and the checks to make sure the application procedure will not be disrupted by these changes. So the key part is the chain and the automated test. So it's a more developer-oriented for any code chain delivery. It should make sure the code can be released to the environment set of tests. The continuous delivery, apart from the code and the automated tests, when we build tests and release software, it should be faster and more frequent way. So for the CI, it should cover plan, code, build, and test. Then we can have the whole process of the CI. But for CD, it should cover the stack
of continuous.
But also there is a continuous deployment.
那持续部署的话呢, continuous deployment is
then the release. So for the CI and the CD,
for the software
delivery, it has a requirement for each feature for the software development. It is after the cold chain deployed to the production environment that it shows that you or your software has completed the feature.
And
to the topic,
today, the topic is how can we use CI/CD tools
to help the applications and the platforms to complete the continuous delivery. So we can have two pathways. This slide to see the pivotal products.
The pivotal products,
I can give you a brief introduction. We have two products. One is PaaS,
Pivotal
Application Service, and also we have a container service called PaaS. PaaS is based on Cloud Foundry. PKS is based on the
KPS.
From this chart, if we want to have a CI of application, we take the upper pathway through GitHub. Operators and containers, it's really difficult. How can we help the applications for operating without downtime? The Kubernetes, each year there is a meaningful version of upgrading. For each time upgrading, the maintainers are really nervous about it. The platform level, at the platform level, each upgrading may cause the downtime or disruption to the business. So on our platform, with the pipeline, we can help the platform maintainers to prevent the downtime. Platform upgrading, for example, the platform itself needs a version upgrade, or you need a CVE. The keynotes today, we hear a lot about security and the kernel upgrading. Through these platforms, continuous delivery from the internet, we can get the latest CVE. Then with the automated pipeline, we can help the platform with rolling upgrading without any disruption to the business. So this is the focus of my presentation, that is CI and CD.
Now
we focus on Concourse.
Concourse
is the open source pipeline tool focus on today. This is developed by Pivotal and is contributed to the source community. Now you take a look at the pipeline's features. Within the Concourse, the pipelines are defined as a single statement configuration file. It has three assets. One is the page software. For example, Jenkins, when you do the file configuration or some plugins, usually you need some plugins
and add-ons
so that you can have some special features. But for Concourse, all the
adds-on
or plugins or new stated resources can be done in the container. You don't need a new add-on for storage. You only need to develop a container, a processor. It can be defined as a source.
我们还是通过一个这个文件，这个文件也很好。
Be mapped into
the
configuration file. It's a standard.
Jenkins 有一个做法是说我的这个 pipeline 的这个写法。
The pipeline writing.
所以呢，你可以看到，就说整个如果在做Concourse的横向扩展，做一些其实是非常容易，based on the container technology，然后扩展呢，会得到很大的一个优势。
And this can help to improve the horizontal scaling capability.
那么我们说呢，其实 Concourse 呢也非常适合去打造。
It's very suitable to build the cloud.
这个是比较典型的一个微服务的一个
化作。It's a very typical scenario to release such a service. If we have many different microservices.
我们传统应用的话，可能跟外部系统来做一些。
We need to integrate with the external services. But for microservices, we can perform some.
做 API 测试，但是最终你还是要做一些
interface test，
你需要做一些，
still,
除了做 mock， 做代
码测试，
你还要做一个
test，
那么你做集成测试的时候呢，
test,
你可以做很多并行的这种一些跑代码测试，最终呢，并且让你最重要的去做一些。
Conclude in one job to
do
the integration. If the microservice is very large, we can open many containers so that they can run together. If you are running a complicated cloud native microservice system, this is very suitable to use. Here is the demo. Probably the network might not work well.But let's have a try. Here we have a Spring Boot construction, and here the
Streams
of
Concourse.
It is one of the
applications.
First, we define that there are different jobs.
And
the build, after the build, we have deploy. And then,
the release.
So together, there are three
jobs.
The input,
Docker image,
and then the Docker image. And
then, the output, push.那么中间的话还有一个环节就是我要
插在，就
我编译出来的这个架包，我需要放在里面。大家可能比较熟的，比如说 Maven 的
，You might be familiar with the Maven's Nexus。
那么我们这边用 JFlow 的这个
Artifactory
去做。那它的这个具体的这个步骤的话呢？
For these specific steps, well, I also put it on a GitHub. If you are interested, you can search it on GitHub. Basically, these are the steps.
Concourse,
there is another advantage.
The UI
shows you the whole control stages. Like you can see three jobs. You need deployed and then release.
那么前面的话呢，我有两个输入，一个是说我的源码，一个呢是我的这个
artifactory。
那么一旦有源码的变化之后，应该可以触发我的
成功。
那我现在的话呢，我稍微改一点点源码。
Now I slightly modified the source code.
比如我现在是1.0。
So now it's 1.0, version 1.0, and then I submit it to Git. So every 1 minute there will be a refresh. During the deployment, I want to finish my follow up.
那我们可以看见啊，就是说，如果我在做这个平台 做应用的交付的时候，一般的这个
application delivery， the workflow will be like this. Well, is something wrong with the slide? Okay.
一般的 workflow 是这样的，
the workflow looks like this. So submit the code and the build, and there will be binary.
这个 binary 的话呢，我们现在会放到我的那个
put it.In our warehouse, which is the warehouse, and then run the test. You can perform some tests or some integrated tests.
And then
the package will be put in the stage for testing whether it is health, whether it can satisfy the end user's requirements, and then deploy to certain production environments. So this is how we deliver the application. The demo.
来源发布呢，其实就是在我
the process. Before we release the new version, we want to guarantee that old version will not be affected. By switching routers, the new version can be smoothly updated. So this is about the delivery of new applications, and this is about our platform. The typical scenario is that we have several upgrades and CVE that need to be updated, and also the platform level updation.
And
this is suitable for the operators to use. The typical scenario here is that we have a new CVE. After we have it, the CVE will be uploaded into our storage. There are two scenarios. One is the public loss. We can update it. And the other is the private loss. Since we iterate our projects, the pipelines will change and become more complicated with the projects. By using Concourse and the configuration files, even when treating such complicated workflow, we can still see the detailed process. And on the top, it's switching different groups. After having many jobs, you can categorize them, and by using different views, you can see clearly, like we can binding with different people playing different roles. And now we can turn back to the demo.
So,
finally, so I have to close the slide first. Finally, we release it in the Cloud Foundry. In the Cloud Foundry, we can see there are two applications are being launched. One is registry demo. Blue and green are two versions. So after releasing blue and green versions, for example, here is the original version, which is the green version. In the green version, we have the independent router. For substitution, since it is binding with the MAC in the group DNS, for switching to blue version, I will first release blue version and then do some test to see if the blue version works well. And then you can see the mend router, we switch it to the blue version. With such a switch, you know, router switches very quickly, we can basically achieve switch without interruption for those businesses. Now we can click on it and visit it. So it's the version 1.0, it might still in the process in the releasing. So after it finished the workflow, it will be updated. So quickly sum up. Something wrong or the projection is a little bit slow?
So, quickly sum up,
the integration and delivery continuously is not only about purchasing tools, not only relying on fully automated without any manual intervention. It's like a whole set of best practice. It requires the effective cooperation among all the involved people, so all the dev and ops they can communicate without any gaps. At the same time, in a very complicated environment, we can release or deliver our latest product. It is with low risk, high frequency, low cost, and rapid, and also predictable. Finally, we can use the cultural and organization structure changes to achieve and realize practices, either for developments or IT missions inside companies. Different companies, they have different process or workflows. If you want to quickly deliver microservices to achieve continuous deployment, this will change the company culture to a certain extent. But it is not only involve pipeline. Having tools is not equal to final success. There are other factors like database migration, risk management, etc. In the company, after applying certain software, you need to control the risk. Otherwise, the existing system or data will be affected. And we need to manage the life cycle and the auditing work, etc. If we want to using CNCD to deliver our application and deliver the platform, the main challenge could be the company culture and then the links to my resources, the link of Concourse, the tutorial of the course, and also some samples. I will not show you now. By clicking on it, you will see the blue version and green version, and also some upgradation for example, like PKA.
PKS,
how to develop a new version of PKS. How to interact with AWS, how to interact with other cloud platforms. We have very rich samples on this link. So this is the end of my